So what happens if your parents show up tonight?
First of all, as far as I'm concerned, they're not even really my parents anymore. But if they did show up, then security can deal with it. I'm not gonna let anyone pick and choose when they want to have my back, especially now that I'm having a little bit of success.
But you haven't talked to them since Calgary, which was like 4 years ago. Maybe it's time you give them another chance.
Another chance to tell me I'm wasting my life and that I'm never gonna make it? Sorry, I don't need that. Besides, I paid them back their money, so the way I see it, we have nothing to discuss.
Hey, I'm not shelling out an extra 20 bucks so you two can have a therapy session.
I handed her the wrench, if that counts. Also, were you listening to our entire conversation?
Hey, I get it. We've all got drama in our lives. I mean, look at me. Last year, I put on a mask and attacked my former protege, Buzz, costing him a shot at WWE. Then he wouldn't return my phone calls or texts for like a year. No one wanted to work with me, and BCW folded. But then I stuck up for Buzz to AJ Styles. And the next thing you know, I'm in Buzz's corner at WrestleMania, and now I'm in the process of rebuilding BCW.
That's a lot of very specific information.
Yeah. What's your point?
My point is, I turn chicken crap into chicken salad. And that's what I can do for you two if you sign exclusive deals with me and become cornerstones of the new BCW.
We actually have been looking for some more stability.
And putting aside all that attacking your protege stuff, you seem like a real stand-up guy, so we're in.
Great! I promise you won't regret this.
Sorry I'm late. Two old-timers got in a fight over who called bingo first, and I had to step in. But Marco said if I keep settling disputes without anyone breaking a hip, then he's gonna let me call the numbers next Tuesday morning.
That's great. How's the house looking tonight?
I think we might get 10 people, which includes two comps I left for some nice ladies from bingo, but still not bad. By the way, pretty sweet the school let us use your office as a locker room. What's wrong?
Let's see. You're a bingo hall security guard, I'm a part-time janitor at our old high school, and we're about to wrestle in front of 10 people.
Actually, the bingo ladies just canceled, so it's 8 now. Apparently there's a ventriloquist at their senior complex tonight. That does sound better than this.
We were on the path to success. We were gonna make it to WWE and achieve all these goals, and maybe even end up in the Hall of Fame someday. Then we signed with Baron Blade and he ruined everything. Now all we have is a meaningless piece of paper that's just a constant reminder of how crappy our lives are.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm up for a promotion and I'm going to see a ventriloquist.
You're bailing on the show?
Yeah, if the entire crowd could have carpooled together, it's probably not worth it. Anyway, you just need to give up on all those dreams and then you'll feel a lot better about how things turned out.
It worked for me.
Man, how do they do that?
I know we failed to crack double digits in attendance tonight, but BCW's this close to turning it all around. Next show, they'll be lining up out the door, or in our case, the large hole in the gym wall that's now used as a door. I know you've seen Red and Josie Jane wrestle 100 times, but they're the only women I can book because, well, I tricked them into signing lifetime exclusive contracts. Piece of advice, read the fine print, people. I regret to inform you that Trey will not be appearing tonight. If you would like a refund, well, look around. You're at the wrong show for that. Red, this place is a mess. How about after your match, you do your job and clean it up? For those of you who don't know, Red moonlights as a janitor and daylights as a failed wrestler. Please be aware that BCW will not be held liable for any injuries occurring at tonight's event, including those suffered from falling roof shrapnel, toxic mold inhalation, or hobo attack. WWE with their fancy network, their big crowds, and their non-condemned arenas, when you can have all of this, right, Red?
facts about the brain and how it starts to deteriorate when we get to 27 or thereabouts.
My point is, I turn chicken crap into chicken salad. And that's what I can do for you two if you sign exclusive deals with me and become cornerstones of the new BCW.
No thanks.
Yeah, we're good.
Your loss. Because FYI, I am this close to getting Cole Quinn on board. Big things are happening. Hey, speak of the handsome devil. Let's go talk numbers, shall we?
Slow your roll, Greenie.
This guy.
I feel like we really dodged a bullet there.
More like a cannonball. That guy's a total nightmare. And here comes another one.
What is she doing here? Holy crap, is that hothead Red and Trey? You two picking up some extra work to make your trailer payments, or is this some kind of prison work release program? It's just Red now, and we're wrestling tonight.
And also, we don't live in trailers. We stay in hotel rooms that have microwaves, which seemed a lot more impressive before I said it.
Wait, you actually became pro wrestlers? And I get to see your uncoordinated bodies flop around this ring tonight?
She's got good lungs.
Of course I do. I'm an elite MMA competitor. If you haven't heard, the American hero, Brooklyn Von Braun, is undefeated. More like American Zero. What's that? Nothing.
You realize Kurt Angle's already known as the American hero, right? You probably should ask him for permission to use his nickname like Ronda Rousey did with Rowdy Roddy Piper.
Kurt Angle? Never heard of him. If anything, he should ask me permission to use my name since I'm way more famous. I'll chat with my lawyer about it. Thanks for the heads up. Why are you here? You're obviously not a pro wrestling fan. No. Gross. There's a ceremony after your stupid show to rename the gym in my honor.
The town sign wasn't enough?
It wasn't. I actually wanted it bigger. Couldn't you have picked any other night to do this? Do you think I chose to share my special night with a professional wrestling event? That'd be like eating a giant bowl of turd soup before having the best steak of your life. I have a loaded schedule and tonight was my only avail.
How much longer would it have taken to say availability?
I told you, I'm busy. Every second counts. I've already wasted way too much time talking to you carnies.
I'll have you know, we've wrestled at several carnivals and their employees are some of the finest people around. Other than that tilt-a-whirl operator who bit me when I asked him what time it was. There's always exceptions.
Cool story. Looking forward to seeing you tap again tonight, Red. You know, just like old times.
Whoa. You could kill someone with that.
I know, that's the point.
Don't let her get under your skin and ruin our night. We'll do our thing, and then she can do her stupid gym dedication. It'll be totally separate. I'm sure we won't even notice her.
Cool.
Here's a scoop for you. I'm currently in negotiations with Cole Quinn to sign a long-term exclusive deal with BCW. In fact, I bet he'll sign on the dotted line right after this match. BCW is on its way back. I may have had to sell my parents' cemetery plots to help fund the relaunch, but I know this is going to work this time. You have my word, Mom and Dad. I got a call from Buzz the other day, and he is doing great. You hear that, Trey? I have big-time connections in WWE. That's what you're missing out on. Special shout-out to all of Red and Trey's friends and family in attendance tonight. And sorry about not being able to let you in for free, but hey, I'm running a business here. I want to thank the high school for letting me run this show tonight without a down payment. I promise, I'm good for it. Make sure you hit up the merch stand at intermission, where I'll be selling actual pieces of the mask I wore last year when I attacked Buzz. Don't miss out on your chance to own a piece of wrestling history. Congrats again on your big homecoming show, Red and Trey. I'm sure nothing will ruin your big night.
Four.
Just a reminder to stick around after the show for a special ceremony where the gym will be renamed for up-and-coming MMA star, the American hero, Brooklyn Von Braun. I wonder if she'd be interested in signing with BCW. Need to settle their differences in the most intimidating and unique structure in wrestling, the Scrap Trap. Sure, it's been banned by every state athletic commission, but not in international waters. Hey, Cole, there's no need to go join your friend Buzz in WWE. Why be the small fish in a big pond when you can be the shark in a kiddie pool? Okay, maybe that's not the best metaphor, since I don't think a shark would survive very long in a kiddie pool, but you get my point. You know, a lot of people doubted Paul Heyman when he was trying to take ECW national. But he did it, and I can do the same with BCW. I mean, yeah, eventually everything fell apart and they went out of business, but you get my point.
It's me, the American hero, Brooklyn Von Braun, taking over on commentary for this match. Commence the flopping of uncoordinated bodies. closes their eyes and just listens to the sweet sound of my voice, I promise the misery will soon be over. Windows to the soul. Well, if I were you, I'd close your eyes unless you want your soul crushed from watching this manure. You could say I know Hothead Red like the back of my hand, as in Red's had the back of my hand upside her head a whole bunch of times. Make sure you stick around for the gym renaming ceremony later tonight. It will help cleanse your palate of whatever this is. This reminds me of our high school dances. A gym full of people all staring at Red saying, "What are those moves?"
Hey, if you want to keep running your mouth, then come over here and do it to my face.
Excuse me for trying to entertain these people, because you certainly weren't. Red acts so tough, but the moment you get her in a submission hold, she gives up immediately. In fact, she's been tapped more than shoulders! Yes, it's finally over. Best of all, Red lost, just like I knew she would. Now we can move on to the real reason everyone's here. The renaming of the gym in my honor.
Being in this gym brings back so many memories. I won my first amateur match here. I broke barriers and records here as the captain of the otherwise all-male wrestling team. I qualified for states here. I dominated gym class dodgeball here. I won prom and homecoming queen here. I once saved Mr. Durkis from choking on a hot dog here.
The banner actually isn't that bad. I was expecting something more obnoxious.
I know, me too.
So that's why it's my pleasure to officially christen this the Brooklyn Von Braun Gymnasium for Athletic Excellence. Isn't it amazing? I want to thank the school board for cutting the music program to help fund this. Totally worth it.
I'm confused. Did she go to space before or after she was Pope?
I think I'm gonna throw up.
Aim towards the mural, if you can.
I can't believe we got totally upstaged and embarrassed by Brooklyn.
Not much has changed.
I know! We've come a long way, but it still feels like we're the same losers who used to sit at this table back in high school.
At least my parents didn't show up and make a scene. Hey, I was thinking, maybe I should try to track down my real parents. They sent that letter back in high school, so maybe there's still hope with them.
I've actually been meaning to talk to you about that letter.
What about it?
Sorry. Anyway.
It's an Orlando number. Take it.
Hello? Hi, Sarah. Yeah, it's a good time to talk. It's Sarah Amato from NXT.
Oh.
I got your number from Xbox. He saw you on a show in LA a couple years ago and said you were great.
Oh, yeah, that was the same night he put my friend in a diaper.
What?
Never mind, had to be there.
Anyways, the reason I'm calling is to see if you'd like to compete in the third annual Mae Young Classic.
What?
Hello, are you there? Hello?
I'm here, and I'm in for the Mae Young Classic. Yes.
Great, we'll be in touch soon with travel arrangements, and congratulations. Being included in this tournament is a huge accomplishment.
Thank you.
We'll talk soon. Bye.
Bye.
Oh, are you serious? Maybe this night wasn't so bad after all.
I know. After I missed out on the first Mae Young Classic and then didn't hear anything last year, I thought I'd never get another shot. But it's happening, and I'm not going to settle for just being included. I'm going to win the whole damn thing.
Oh, I know you will. We should celebrate.
By throwing rocks at Brooklyn's stupid face.
That might be a bit extreme. I mean, what size rocks are we talking?
I meant her face on the sign coming into town.
Oh. Yeah, that seems slightly more reasonable. Hey, what did you want to tell me about the letter?
Oh. Never mind. It's not important. Besides, there's a sign that needs vandalizing, remember?
True. I'll go round up some good throwing rocks.
That's a great idea. I'll meet you at the car in a minute.
Cool.
Whoa, that's a shock. He's always wanted to meet his birth parents, and now that we know what happened, what are we gonna say when he asks about them?
I really don't think he can handle the truth that they're dead. Do you?
No, it would crush him. But what's the alternative, honey? Just let him believe they're still out there somewhere and they don't care enough to ever contact him?
I don't know. I wish there was a way to keep his hope alive, but not hurt him.
Me too.
You've probably asked yourself a million times, why? Why didn't they want to be my parents? The truth is, we did. But we had to make the hardest decision of our lives because we didn't feel we could give you the life you deserved. And that life is one where you can have the freedom to follow your dreams, no matter what they might be. To become anything you want. We'll find you someday. Love always, Mom and Dad. Please, don't tell him our secret about the letter. It's not going to help anything.
Hey, you coming or what?
Yeah, sorry. Let's do this!